All right, here's the thing. We're going to get to romantic tips, voice tips, and great new music. Mark Ballas and BC Jean, of course, make up Alexander Jean. They're here. It's a newlywed time, and I said, how's it going?
Yeah.
Please detail the marriage as if he's not here.
No, things have been great. We've been working hard, and we got a new house, and we're just excited. You know, we get to do everything we love together, and newlywed life's pretty good.
It feels the same, but elevated.
Okay, but no, now you're married. How long were you guys together prior to getting married?
Like 4 years, a little over 4 years.
All right, so I bet it's a question your unmarried friends ask you all the time. Is it any different?
Yes.
Yeah, it is. I mean, we felt like we went to a new level when you got engaged, and then after the wedding, you feel like, oh, this is an even newer level.
Right. And if he's in the doctor's, like, I don't have to wait in the waiting room. I'm like, no, that's my husband. Like, all right, this way.
I'm his wife. I'm like, all right, this way.
Yes. That's right. See, the Mrs. Ballas, is that every time you hear it go, oh.
I know, I feel so adult.
Yeah, right.
I have new responsibility.
Great, we're going to listen to new music, but before we do, last time you were here, we were talking about the Frankie Valli.
Jersey Boys.
And you did it for a zillion shows.
I did, yeah.
And what a real, and boy, the dancing is an athletic endeavor, but this is an athletic endeavor to preserve your voice.
Indeed, yeah.
So what were all these techniques that you learned about?
Well, they had a fantastic coach named Katie Agresta, who I'm still using all her techniques when we're on tour doing our shows, because they were really helpful. And, you know, it's a 45-minute warm-up. And the key is to warm down after the show. You know, after the show, you're meeting people, you're talking, and I would make sure I had 20 minutes in the dressing room to warm down my voice. And then, you know, I wouldn't talk till about 2 p.m.
He's very responsible.
I would steam. I had throat coat teas, you know, gargling whiskey or apple cider vinegar. Oh. And all these, like, tricks lived on throat coat
Mark's been doing stuff to preserve his voice and fine all the time.
Wow. I had no idea.
No trouble with it.
What's harder to keep in tip-top shape, your voice or your body for dancing?
They're different.
Yeah.
You know, it just depends. I mean, vocally, when you're doing a Frankie Valli track, it's one of the most demanding roles on Broadway, and you're doing it 6 times a week.
Right.
So it's a lot of maintenance, and even when you get the day off, then you got to do it all over again, you know? So I feel like the discipline on that is you've really got to be focused.
Did you go, I can't do
that? Oh, yeah, all day. All day. Tongue pulling, biting, biting towels. We have all
that. You guys should do like a wedding smooch where you go, to the wedding day, a new song coming out. And tell me about this idea about putting your vows in a box. That sounds so interesting to me.
Yeah, well, I mean, Mark did that. We both did handwritten personal vows, and after the wedding, he wanted to save them and put them in a little box. And, you know, it was like an origami situation, and it kind of inspired the paper plane
song. I'm a borderline hoarder. Like, I keep all my memories, and I like boxes. So I gave my groomsmen these beautiful cigar boxes with their names engraved, and I got one, too. So at the end of the night, you know, our vows were on the side, and I wanted to make sure we kept them for later, so we frame them or something or show our kids. And when we folded them up, I was like, oh, kind of like origami or like a paper plane.
Yeah.
And that's where the inspiration
You can
comes
see
from.
Your two personalities that's just at the denim jackets. His,
no,
a bunch of buttons all over the fingers.
We were rushing out of the house this morning. I was like, we just sat down.
We're like, oh, we're
You're the minimalist.
Here's a little bit of the music video, which features, as you saw, a little bit footage from the wedding. Watch this. Those shots, you remind me. I think there's a part for every man during the wedding when you realize, oh, this is actually happening.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. And I was like, I'm not going to cry. I get emotional. I was like, I'm not going to cry. And then BC walked the aisle to Bohemian Rhapsody.
Oh, wow.
And she looked stunning.
Yes,
and then, like, the mixture of that song and the dress. And then I was like,
where was that?
Calamigas Ranch in Malibu.
Yeah.
New EP is called High Enough, and you guys are doing a performance and a release party, a fundraising event Sunday.
Yeah.
Fundraising event Sunday, and then our EP release party is going to be on the 27th.
At Sayers Club. Yeah.
All right, all of it on KTLA.com, and it's all here
there
right there.
Yeah.
And the album is available now, the EP. Kids, nice to see you both.
Hey, man, thank you guys. Always a pleasure.
You bet, absolutely.
Thank you.